Isn't that good? All right, these brothers are doing excellent. We got a lot to look for this month. Every brother. Amen. This time we're going to ask Elder Wayne to come. I think that we're going to be starting to honor him real soon. All right, let's receive it by saying amen. Man of great wisdom, great revelation of the word. Brother Wayne.
Purpose, not just for this ministry, just us individually. no matter where you at, no matter what facet of life you in, praise God. Don't just stay there. Continue to trust God. Continue to expand, as Brother Trevor has talked about, his faith and your faith continually, praise God, walking in the hand of God and being obedient to him, he's going to bless you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He's going to work in your behalf. And I shared this on, believe it like Monday, with a testimony regarding, praise God, the thing that happened in our life that we were facing. You know, I just thank God for his faithfulness. He truly is faithful. I mean, that's why I say it's so important. I really believe that on Monday nights or Tuesday morning, whatever, you know, Sunday morning, whatever time prayer schedule, we ought to be filled this place. It shouldn't be just 10:30 on Sunday morning that we see everybody, but the fullness of this ministry. Not in this day and time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I mean, these services of prayer should be filled with the saints of God. Because, you know, me, myself, and my family, and my wife have been experiencing it. Just seemed like, most people might seem like minor, but it was a nagging thing, this constant nagging, you know, constant being harassed, you know. Wanted to attack our finances, praise God. Never was the thief come. He comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Hallelujah. But I thank God that Jesus said he came that we might have life, and life more abundant. But we got to do our part. I mean, we just think we can take the back seat and just ride this road a bit of ease, you know what I mean? And think life is not going to come at you, or the devil not going to attack you some way or some form. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the particular thing that we had dealing with, as I shared, I believe, on Monday night, I believe it was, regarding, somebody heard me mention something regarding the plumbing issues and so forth. And initially the problem kind of started where, you know, it caused the plumbing back up in the house and so forth. And we wound up calling this one particular plumber out. And, you know, he tried to do his best to, you know, to fix the problem, wasn't able to. And I paid him, I think at the time, $50. You know, that's for the service charge that he said he would charge, but still the problem persists. And thank God for Brother Holman for the information that he had shared with me regarding, you know, how some of the stuff is laid out in that particular area on that street that we live on. And, and we wound up calling this one guy out, and he, you know, ran his camera there and so forth, and did ran his tests, and come to find out, he said, "Well, looks like your problem definitely ends in the middle of the street," and you know, and I said, you know, talking with him, I said, "You sure about that?" He said, "Yeah, based on the camera that we ran through there, is run by over the north lane of the street going north." And I'm like, "Lord Jesus, all I know is," and he said, that didn't sound good, and he said it don't seem like it was more of a bigger problem that he's able to deal with himself. And he thinks that he had a problem. I mean, that's definitely way bigger problem than I won't even can imagine. And anyway, I wound up, you know, paying him for his services. So for all this time, this is like from 1 week to another week, you know, like I said, you know, plumbing back over the house and so forth. And one guy come out there, kind of relieved it somewhat, but still didn't take care of the problem. And all I know is, you know, just to the thought of mine that God was, you know, wanting me to do, just continue to praise him. And I just, you know, realized, "Lord, this particular deal doesn't seem like something I should be dealing with or even facing." And, you know, and that's the way it is a lot of time in our life, that we, you know, things that come after us. Because the Bible said, "Those that live godless world shall suffer persecution." And those things, we don't like that facet of our life as a believer. We want things to go easy, go smoothly, God calls, he answer. I mean, you know, we call the angels, they show up and bring out whatever we need at our doorstep. Hallelujah. But when he doesn't answer, when he don't show up right then, what do you do? Hallelujah. I mean, that is the time that you continually being faithful because you know to whom you serve. You know that he is able. Matter of fact, scripture says he's more than able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we think of as according to the power that works within us. Hallelujah. And we had to continue as we got so much maturity regarding the Word of God and our access to be the access to build us up. Now, did I get kind of concerned about this? Yes, because they was going to say, well, you are responsible for this. And of course, in my mind, I couldn't comprehend how I was, but nevertheless, this is what was laid before. And I just, you know, began to think in my mind about, I was asking, well, about how much this might cost. You're talking about they had to wind up hiring a flagman and all this and here, they had to call out these people to cut up the street. And you talked about several thousand, even up to about $6,000 to repair. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And, you know, I can begin to think in my mind, well, this, you know, this money going to come about because this has got to be fixed. I mean, Sister Wayne, you don't stay with me in the house like this. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I think I just continue to pray, continue to come out here Monday nights. You know? And that's how you had attacked your situation. I mean, I don't know what you're facing, but you know where you're at. You know what's going on in your life. Hallelujah. The Bible said, cast your cares upon him. Glory to God. And that's what I began to do. Lord, you see this problem? You hear what they're saying? What's going on? I don't know how to deal with this. Don't you know who to talk to? Call this one, call down the city. They said, nah, that's your responsible. You know, so I'm like, okay, well, can you help me any kind of way? No, but you got to take care of that because we're getting ready. If you don't fix it real quick, we're going to remove your water heater. Water meter. Hallelujah. I said, well, thank you for your help. But I just continue to come, press on down here Monday. Hallelujah. Keep coming Wednesday. Keep coming Sunday. Hallelujah. Keep praising God. Keep thanking him for the answer. Because, Lord, I don't know what to do. Unless you do it, Lord. And continue, you know, making my petition be made known unto him. And continue to praise and worship and magnify him. Hallelujah. We have a friend in Jesus. Hallelujah. I mean, you can literally cast your burdens upon the Lord. This was a burden to me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I wound up having, of course, call another plumber out. And this particular individual came out there, ran his camera in, under there, and so forth, and did his testing, and he concluded that it made it to the other side. I like that. I mean, now we're getting somewhere on the other side. Hallelujah. Hey, this took a plumber here to become my friend. Hallelujah. And he did not charge me anything. The favor of God. Let me encourage you, if you haven't figured out yet to start giving tithes and offering to the Lord, let me encourage you to start doing so. That's the foundation. That's the first word. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. And after he told me that, you know, that he had come out on the other side, and he gave me his estimate, which his estimate still just to repair it, but one, I think he gave me an estimate of almost two grand. Then another estimate, I think he said he just to repair it or just replace the line, which wanted me going under the road without cutting the road up. And that was about three. I'm like, oh, well, praise the Lord. That sounds a little bit encouraging.